thanks for the introduction. So guys, we had Bihar just voted today, and I have with me some very eminent people from Bihar. I have Harsh, he's a techie, works in the IT sector, very passionate about his own home state. Siddhant, of course, is not from Bihar, but because he works in news with me, he's almost a Bihari now. Sarthak has his roots from Bihar, he's an entrepreneur, he's in the chemicals and dyes business. Again, very passionate about the state. Nitesh Rana, he's a top lawyer, work in the Supreme Court, comes from a political family of Bihar. Not that he carries his politics up his sleeves. He's here, he's very neutral in terms of his assessment of the political situation. Shanwaz works in a leading multinational company right here in Delhi. So we have all these guys here. Let's start here. Harsh, you're the youngest of us all here. You, of course, didn't go to vote. A lot of people from your generation would have voted, considering that it's quite a high voter turnout that we saw today, about 60% people casted their vote. If you had voted, and the friends that of yours who have voted, the youngsters especially, you know, those, a lot of non-resident Biharis went and voted, what do you think was the top of their mind when they casted their vote?
See, what I feel is, initially, BJP had started off on a very strong footing. And even if I had to, you know, cast my vote, if you would have asked me, about 3 weeks back, I would have gone with BJP. But given the, you know, current scenario, the, you know, all these incidents which are happening and the communal tinge to them, I mean, people have, I think, I feel, become a bit more wary of, giving their vote for the BJP. So if personally I would have been there, and I think I would have gone with the, you know, JDU most probably. And that is what I think even the youth over there are a bit hesitant in, you know, going with BJP, given the, you know, communal tensions which have, you know, started springing up. You have in Maharashtra today, as you know, that the whole painting happened, yeah, and all those incidents. So people have become a bit uneasy. That is,
Siddhant, once before you start, you are the only one here who can actually see Bihar from a Sakshi Bhav, because you are passionate about Bihar and not a Bihari yourself. What's your take on it? I mean, don't you think that your generation voted for this government with such a huge majority? It was a too many contradictions were at play 1 year back. Do you think those contradictions have settled down and people are looking for, you know, things more basic, things more fundamental as far as the election campaign is concerned? You don't want to get into a beef debate after all as far as your voting is concerned.
Definitely not. And you know, that's where something that Harsh just said. He said if he'd be there right now, he'd vote for the JDU. But it's not just the JDU on that side. There's Lalu Yadav as well, which, you know, makes a big difference. If I have to look at it, I would go for the BJP just because of their points on development, rather than, you know, even looking at that entire angle of all this mudslinging that's been happening, the beef incidents and things like that. So for me, I think the BJP is definitely ahead, because finally, when you weigh both of them, when you weigh the all these incidents as against the development agenda, you definitely weigh the development a lot more. And Lalu Yadav added to the equation on the Mahagathbandhan side, I think is a lot of votes going to the BJP.
That's about votes. Sarthak, you're a businessman. How's generally the scenario? Like, how do businessmen see this election? You don't have, of course, business interests in Bihar, but coming from a business background, how your, you know, strata of the society, the businessmen, a lot of Biharis have made it very big here in Delhi in terms of businesses and all that. How does your strata of the society view these elections?
See, I think as a businessman, I would say most businessmen, you know, have seen Bihar not change so much over the years, and which is, you know, a long process where parties have come and go. You know, JDU at one point was working with BJP, JDU is working alone. I don't think so. I think as a businessman, I haven't generally seen a change in Bihar, which was always promised. I personally, if I would have been a Bihari right now, sitting in Bihar, having to vote, I would vote for BJP only for the reason because they are in center. So if the Sarkar comes in Bihar of BJP, there'll be a lot of support. The state would get, and the state would get its, you know, earmarked development which it's been looking for. I have a fear that if JDU comes to power, then you know what is happening in Delhi would happen again, that people would not get the kind of the government would not get the kind of support from center which is looking for, and we have seen that in Delhi, and I think that's going to repeat itself in Bihar. So I personally would be a little selfish here and not look at the caste, not look at the development agenda. I would just vote for BJP, so that, because I am pretty sure if BJP comes to power in Bihar, given that this elections is pretty much a do or die for Nitish Kumar, because if he wins, he's going to pretty much come up as, you know, a singleton force against Modi, but if he is gone, he'll be, you know, drafted into oblivion. So, yeah, for me, I would personally think, you know, I would not think about these things. I would think about, you know, as a Bihari, I would think, you know, of development of Bihar, and I would vote for BJP just because they are in center and for the support the center would be giving to state. I don't think so BJP would actually come up or fulfill its promises if JDU comes to power, which is, you know, the money which they have promised. I don't think so, and this has happened in the past as well. I don't think so that will happen.
But then Bihar has always been a very compulsive contrarian. If you remember, in 2004, Bihar gave a huge in parliament elections mandate to Lalu Yadav and Congress, and then Congress came to power. Just 6 months later, state elections were held, and then Bihar voted heavily in favor of Nitish Kumar while Congress was in center.
But,
so it's a state of great contradiction.
But I think Bihar suffered because of that. If that would have been the case, if Bihar would have actually voted Congress to power in state as well, I think they would have seen a lot of development. But because they did the whole state thing versus the center thing, in state they voted for their leader, in center they voted for somebody else, they actually did not. As much as we praise Nitish Kumar for his development, actual development has actually not happened in Bihar. And I think it's time that, you know, center and state have the same governments and that kind of model be applied.
Nitish, you've got businesses in Bihar and you are a very successful lawyer. Your family's got businesses in Bihar. You went to the infrastructure sector there, back then in the state. You are yourself a very successful lawyer sitting here in Delhi. You've got your family roots still there. You'd be talking very frequently to them. What's your take in the first round of polls that the state has done so far?
See, what I believe, if BJP is succeeded in wooing youth of Bihar, if across the party line youth of Bihar is like going towards BJP, the BJP succeeds.
Chanwar, let me ask you a very communal question, quote-unquote a communal question to start with. Muslim youth, what do you think, do they like Modi?
Okay, before answering to that question, I think I'm the only one who is going to vote. Because back home, polling is on 5th of November and I'm looking
for... Who are you voting for? So of course, it's a secret ballot. I'll not ask you to divulge who you're voting
for.
Yeah,
okay, I won't tell whom I'm voting, but I'm supporting the Margaret Burner. And asking the question, the communal question. See, in Bihar, the narrative, if you have noticed, has changed not once, not twice, but many a times in the last 1 month. Initially, what happened, the Prime Minister went, he announced a package of 1,25,000 crore rupees. If you remember, there was a lot of hue and cry, debates, whether the figure was right, Nitish Kumar coming and rebutting. That became the central point. And Muslim youth, let me say, some of them were thinking of going towards the BJP. But then what happened was something that took them away from BJP. Things like what happened in Dadri, things like what happened in Manpuri. Manpuri was bigger than Dadri. Because in Manpuri, it was not a rumor that was spread, it was a pre-planned conspiracy. That is A. B, it's not the society that fell, it's also the government. Because there were member of parliaments, ministers going and making derogatory comments, inciting the mob. That's A that happened. So yes, the fear of being on a receiving end,
yeah,
on the marginalized side came to the youth. That's A. B, you see what has happened in Bihar now. How many times in the last 4-5 public speeches has the Prime Minister talked about 1,25,000 crore rupees? Where is that money? Who is talking about that? No, we are talking about whether beef should be banned. The most prominent leader, Mr. Sushil Modi, he is promising that we will ban beef in Bihar if voted to power. Let me tell you, it has been banned. There is a legislation in place since 1955. So whom are they fooling? It's not development at all. If you are fooling people in the name of legislation, saying, promising a legislation which is already there, that's A. B, we are talking about Nitish Kumar, and there are people saying that, you know, with Nitish we have the fear of corrupt regime coming and all. We remember what happened to a minister in his government just yesterday. first instant of a sting on a minister.
But that could be symbolic. Let's not get into that. That could be symbolic. I mean, yes, you know that elections are wrong.
Symbolism works. Has the BJP gone ahead? Because ADR, if you go by the ADR report, most of the candidates on whom there is a criminal case pending are from BJP. So, who is perpetuating Jangal Raj in the state?
So, tell me one thing, Shahnawaz. You think is BJP trying purposefully, trying to replicate the UP model of general elections here in Bihar in assembly election, because Muzaffarnagar happened in general elections, they sweep UP.
They are importing Dadri.
In their mind, they want to repeat that kind of scenario in BJP?
They are importing Dadri in Bihar.
So, but do you think they want a complete, rather than a caste vote, they want a Hindu-Muslim vote to happen in Bihar? That's what they're hoping, you think?
They want to do everything they can to ensure Bihar. If you see the entire cabinet is sitting in Bihar, except for few, who are not supposed to be ground leaders. The entire cabinet is in Bihar. The Prime Minister is, we can say that he is staying most of the times in Bihar.
So the new capital of India is Patna.
The political capital right now is Patna. If you want any, ask any big bureaucrat if they want to get files signed. I'm thinking they might be going to Patna and getting it signed.
So you are essentially saying that all these factors will come. Nitesh, you tell me one thing. We last heard Bihar has gone for more than 60% polling. Is it a vote for change or is it a mark of confidence?
Absolutely, I believe, considering the situation of previous elections, it's absolutely vote for change. If it goes beyond 62-63%, it's absolutely...
It's about 61%. I mean, that's the polling is officially...
Closed. Absolutely, you can think. It's 65. like a neck-to-neck fight, but still it's a vote for change.
No, in fact, I was just corrected by Leela. It's not very heavy polling. I was just corrected by Leela. It's about 50%, you told me? As of 3 p.m., no. Then,
as of 5 p.m., it's 54%. So
it'll be in the range of 60%.
Even,
in the range
see, of 60%. My contention is, even if it is 55 to 60%, here youth, let's talk about youth, have nothing to do with beef. They are not affected by the beef politics, which is going on in Bihar. They are absolutely thinking on the line of development. And whoever is coming there for development, they will definitely vote for the party. One more thing, let me add more thing. Secondly, in JDU alliance, if you see Lalu Prasad, conduct of Lalu Prasad, previous history, youth is absolutely disappointed with Lalu. And youth do not want to vote Lalu.
So Lalu rather than being a strength, Lalu has ended up being as a baggage.
Liability.
It's a baggage.
Okay.
It's a very strong statement. Lalu has been
a liability for them.
But at the same time, I'm telling you,
I'm giving a statement that Lalu is a political liability for any party in today's time.
But I agree with the Yadav are still supporting, at least from the pre-poll surveys, it looked like the Yadavs are still supporting Lalu Prasad Yadav. And by that logic, they will actually vote for Mahagath Bandhan.
Actually, the Yadavs are supporting for one reason, that they don't have option right now. One leader which is coming up from Yadavas is Pappu Yadav, but considering his criminal background, they are not able to connect. However, Yadavs have no options. That is why they are with Lalu.
But there's one more point.
Like to vote for a Hindu candidate rather than saying, won't Yadav forget about their caste and then grow and vote for BJP for development?
It's a very good question. See, it is, if you're thinking Lalu Yadav or JDU Gathbandhan has only given tickets to Yadavs, it is not that. The same constituency, BJP has given tickets to Yadavas. So
my understanding of the dominant backwards in Bihar, that's my limited understanding from the political landscape of Bihar, is that the dominant castes of Bihar, especially the dominant backward castes like Yadavs and Kurmis, they don't essentially want to elect an MLA. They want to elect a chief minister. This is for the first time that a Yadav chief minister is not in the fray. Does it mean that the Yadavs are not voting for a chief minister here and they are voting for MLAs?
Very good question. First of all, I'll give you the little bit of graphics of Bihar. Yadavas are about 12%. Kurmis, 12 to 13%. Kurmis are much lesser, about 3 to 4%, which is a Kuswaha. This one caste called Kuswaha, people confused with Kurmis.
They are Khoiris.
And their population is very large, about 12%. And the entire, it's about 11%.
Yeah.
So, entire population of Khoiris vote goes to NDA Alliance. No, I'm sure about that. And as far as...
But why? Upendra Kushwaha is not becoming chief minister.
Doesn't matter, but he's in the...
Their only representation is in the coalition.
And secondly, they have voted for BJP in previous parliament election. We have to understand this fact also. Secondly, Nitish Kumar would have been in better position if Lalu was not with JDU.
See, I agree that Nitish would have been in a better position had he not gone with Lalu. But the fact, there is a fact that remains that in the last 25-30 years of Bihar, the only mascot of change and a positive change that people saw was Nitish Kumar. Be it in alliance with BJP or not, be it part of NDA or not, but he's the only face-minded who drove Bihar towards development. I know many people who went back to Bihar, started their own startups or business or whatsoever. See, the NDA alliance does not have a face. So we cannot say that, you know, it's not Nitish, but it is X, Y, Z who will bring development.
You know, Shanu, they have a face.
Considering that, I'm making some
statements. Okay,
I'm making some statements to all of you over here. I'm making some statements. Just tell me, just answer, you know, those statements in yes or no, if the statements that I'm making are correct or not. And then I'll come to, I have an analysis myself, and I'll come to that analysis based on the question that I'm putting to the house right now. In April of 2014, Narendra Modi's popularity was at an all-time peak. Do you agree or not?
Completely.
Since then, he might have lost certain percentage points in terms of popularity.
Good percentage.
Certain. Let's assume all percentage. Now, I'm assuming, and I know politics is not about calculation. Bihar, at least, is about a very complex chemistry and not about mathematics at all. Right now, I'm just basing some prognosis on vague calculations here. So you guys are in agreement when I say that Narendra Modi was at an all-time popularity high in April of 2014 when this country voted him with a 282 strength in the parliament elections. I'm making a second statement. Nitish Kumar was at the bottom of his popularity in April of 2014.
Agree.
Can Nitish Kumar's popularity erode any further than what it was in 2014 when he had got literally discredited? People were saying that he has made the most stupid mistake of his life to have left Narendra Modi. He did not have a vote bank to go to polls with.
He even resigned himself.
The solid caste groups that voted for BJP, that are going to vote for BJP today, do you think any of those caste groups voted for Nitish Kumar in April of 2014?
No. He's come back strongly.
Then where did the 18% vote that Nitish Kumar got in 2014 came from? Let's not forget the fact that at the bottom of his popularity index, when he had no substantial caste groups, no substantial social groups backing him, Nitish Kumar was still at an 18% vote bank in Bihar in an election that was a wave election for Narendra Modi.
I would answer.
I'm just trying to ask you, who were the
18%? I'll answer this question. See, Nitish Kumar per se, one person, people voted for good governance, that 18% vote, as Mayur is saying. Rightly accepted. But at that point of time, Lalu Yadav was not part of that alliance.
But don't you think that
secondly,
this,
those 18%, let me just say, those 18%, out of that, I'm sure about 60-70% has moved to BJP in this election.
Which is their social group? Tell me, which is the new
social group? I'll give you
18%, you can't divide into social group.
No, I will give you a dominant group. I will give you a dominant group.
Put anything in the 17%.
Sir, we are talking
no,
about...
No, you can't.
No.
Then who voted for Lalu?
I'll tell you.
Who voted for Congress?
There is a group. We are talking about Yadavs. We are talking about Muslims, Koiris, Kurmis.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
We are not talking about a very dominant number, which is women. No one talks about them. But see, the biggest beneficiaries of Nitish's regime have been the women of Bihar.
I
and if you go back to journalists who reported, who spoke to women, and especially the women journalists who spoke to women, they have come up front. I know my neighbors who have voted for someone else, Congress or BJP, but their wives or daughters, they've gone and voted for JDU. Why? An 8th standard kid or 10th class kid, a girl child,
are they
going to school, getting bicycle because they got the first rank.
No, are they still going to JDU? Is this section still with JDU?
Yes.
I would rather add one more thing. See, 18% which Nitish got in previous election, you can't divide into any caste community back because that 18% vote was given for good governance.
But that 18% vote, Nitish, was given to Nitish Kumar when Narendra Modi was running for the prime ministership of this country. Right now, you're voting for a chief minister. You're not voting for Narendra Modi as the chief minister of Bihar.
Absolutely right. I'll give you a village graph. See, it is not that there was. Let's take one village.
Imagine you are voting for Dr. Prem Kumar as Bihar CM.
Prem Kumar of Gaya.
Do you think that Dr. Prem Kumar of as the Chief Minister of Bihar stands
for
wise on that aspect?
But Shahnawaz Hussain is also a little separated from the Modi side.
See, this is a very wise decision that the BJP has not confirmed the Chief Minister candidate.
I don't think so. Even the public, if you ask the general public, they would even know about Prem Kumar.
Assuming it's a Nitish Kumar Prem Kumar election.
Sartak, common public of Haryana did not know who Manohar Lal Khattar was. And common public of Jharkhand did not know
who Raghubar Das was.
Precisely. People following politics might have known, but a common man did not know who Raghubar Das or Manohar Lal Khattar was.
I'm saying even today they would not know Prem Kumar. We, you and me, because we
see,
are following
don't go by this fact that Prem
I don't think so. They would actually, somebody who's going to vote for him doesn't know about Prem Kumar.
Absolutely. Why are you discussing about that?
What is a Prem Kumar versus Nitish Kumar?
If this statement comes from Narendra Modi, we can discuss about that.
Why does BJP not come out in the open and deny that this is not a party?
Because today was a day, because today is an election day. How would you come out?
No. It's a very sensitive issue.
It's a sensitive issue.
A senior leader of the party is officially saying that this guy is not Chief Minister. And the party does not come out to deny it.
Let's just say he made an off-the-cuff remark, but now if they and deny it...
It was not an off-the-cuff remark, it was a remark given from a political podium. And it's been 8 hours.
I don't think so. He got it with the backing of the parliamentary.
However, I'll just tell you, this is the first phase of election. In course of time, let's see, BJP may deny this fact. According to the today's voting.
Yes.
So, he's a non-existent person. Let's not talk about it. If this statement was given by a Prime Minister, we can discuss about it. Otherwise, there's no point. See, few days back, Giriraj Singh says that any backward or Dalit will become the Chief Minister. Later, that was withdrawn. So, it's not
but
a topic then, to talk,
yeah,
talk about.
But what I'm coming to is that, fact of the matter is that 18% of the people voted for Nitish Kumar when they knew that their vote is going down the drain. Don't you think that 18% suppose we take out 2-3% that Jitendra Manjhi may have taken out of Nitish's coffer, don't you think it's this 14-15% that still wants to see Nitish Kumar as the Chief Minister of Bihar?
That 14-15-16%, whatever may be,
yeah,
that is also, there is a division in it, because 18-17 months of BJP government have definitely some breakups you will see. That 18% vote had gone to Nitish Kumar just for good governance across the caste community and everything. But there is a division now.
Also, Mayur, I'd ask you something. I think what you're exactly saying is those 18% would vote for him, which basically are completely backing him whether Modi is there or not. And there'll be, of course, new people. So you're saying maybe if he had 18% but there was nothing going for him, now he would definitely have a larger number.
Absolutely.
But my point is you're not considering the fact that a lot of those people might lose, you know, that time they were just voting for Nitish Kumar. Now there is a whole different angle. There is a whole Mahagathbandhan. Do you think those people might change a little bit, thinking they are not voting for?
That's what I'm trying to understand.
So I'm saying maybe that 18% doesn't count now. Maybe that time when Nitish Kumar was single-handedly staring at the barrel, you know, then it counted. But right now,
and it could also be candidates.
But you know, Sartak, back home, secondly, people say that a Bihari voter or a voter from UP does not vote for harne wala candidate.
They don't vote for a losing candidate.
If people voted for Nitish Kumar when he was going to lose, everyone knew he was going to lose. If those people stuck by Nitish Kumar,
it's a very loyal vote base.
But don't you think they would actually get, I mean, if we are considering they are the woman vote we are considering, or don't you think they'll get affected by this whole Lalu Yadav association?
No, but the fact that Nitish Kumar is going to be
the Chief Minister candidate,
great comfort.
Better.
Because the fact is that Sushil Modi has no governance track record. You're not even sure if you're going to make Sushil Modi the Chief Minister or not.
Yeah.
And then the Manohar Lal Khattar type of an experiment has given this point across that BJP might actually go for a dummy Chief Minister. A dummy Chief Minister is a big fear that today Biharis are having. So that, what role do you think campaigning is playing? The same guy who devised Narendra Modi's campaign, he's your friend, I know. Same guy, Prashant Kishore, is now devising Nitish Kumar's campaign. It's very tech-driven. How do you think it's going to go?
There's a fundamental difference between the two candidates or the two parties that he was making campaign.
Or the two products that he was trying to
Narendra market. Modi is very different from Nitish Kumar.
So you said that Nitish Kumar is not sellable?
Yeah, strategies just go so far. It's also about the charisma and the leadership qualities of the fellow. And if you look at the statements that, you know, Nitish Kumar made a lot of statements that did not go down very well.
Like?
With the media or with, I don't remember them exactly right now. But this is about, I think, 2 weeks ago or something that he made some statements in a rally. I think the persona that Modi carries with himself is the game changer in Bihar. It's not about having, you know, about someone announcing the candidate's name or about Sushil Modi. It's a fight between
Narendra Modi and Nitish Kumar.
And the bigger thing at play here is that if Nitish comes back, he actually becomes one of the biggest faces on the national front as an opponent to Narendra Modi. And that is something that I really think the NDA is looking to counter here.
I'll give you one more picture of a village or panchayat level. See, where you see Yadava's populations are there. It is not that, and there may be other backwards Dalits in the village. But it is not that if entire population is voting for a JDU alliance. Where Yadava's populations are there, they harass rest of the community in and around. Being in power, this has happened in the history. So, other against Yadavas, rest of them will vote for NDA. This is the scenario of village. What will happen in that?
But then where BJP has a Yadava candidate?
BJP
is about 30 other
candidates. So, there's a difference there. BJP's Yadav candidates have the face of Modi.
Correct.
But there's a flip side to it, if you have a BJP Yadav candidate, and when we're talking about Yadavs being politically dominant and harassing other communities, let's say if there's a BJP Yadav candidate, are we sure that the typical vote bank of BJP is going to vote for a Yadav MLA in that area?
They also might think of it as a jungle Raj. Yadav is also a
certain. Also, your question was on campaign. Let me bring an interesting thing. You see BJP's campaign and you see Nitish Kumar's campaign, and it reminds me of Delhi. BJP going for big public meetings where people from different assemblies are coming together, and Nitish Kumar going for smaller public meetings the way Arvind Kejriwal went. Are you looking at the way they are campaigning?
I don't know.
Chief Minister.
We thought Kejriwal is gonna go.
There's no doubt about it. The most popular leader. However, largest business community and rest of the, except Yadavas, rest of the population, they still consider to vote NDA for the fact that Lalu Yadav is in this alliance.
I agree.
So that is a very first. So Lalu Yadav is a baggage.
But Lalu is not the dominant player.
Why are we ignoring today's time when this is a neck-to-neck fight? Why are we ignoring Obaisi and Pappu Yadav's candidate?
I don't think Obaisi is getting even 500.
I am telling you, 1,000 vote, 2,000 vote.
You think he'll take the votes away from
Let's take it like, even Obaisi's candidates takes 2,000 vote or Pappu Yadav's candidates get 2,500 votes. That is the margin of winning in this election.
And we all know it's going to be a 2%, 5% swing.
So my prognosis here is that Mahagathbandhan will definitely get 40% votes. NDA will definitely get 40% votes. It's the 3-4% fringe votes that will eventually decide the outcome of the election.
And one final point. Delhi, when elections happened, assembly elections, Delhi voted around 57-58%. And with that number, political pundits were saying that, you know, this is a number that will throw Arvind Kejriwal off. What happened was different.
We almost gave the final stats. We have 57% polling in Bihar. Which is equal to Delhi, which is very close. 57% polling in Bihar means that we are headed to an election which is too close to call. But then let's hope the election throws up a result that people like Harsh can, you know, go back to Bihar and start some technology business.
This is the first phase of election. Wait for some more time. There are 3 more phases to go. So see, maybe a larger number of seats in this first phase of election was of JDU alliance. Now we have elections are moving to the NDA alliance seats and all, then you see the number, you know, what
percentage. I agree totally.
I think the voting percentage would actually
increase. India TV had been doing these series of shows where they would have like an audience, locals, and they would have a couple of candidates who would stand there. So there was one that I saw, and that had one guy from Congress, one guy from the JDU.
Yeah.
And the audience was actually talking about things like FDI, right?
Yeah, that's what.
About electricity, right? So they were definitely split, but I think this audience really understands what's happening at the national level as well. And if they're praising things like FDI, you know, I think they really do understand that we're making some difference.
Actually, you know, on that note, I have a question to ask. I think a lot of people are calling these elections a Vikas ka election. But when they say that people will be voting for Vikas, who are they actually talking about? Are they talking about JDU? Because I think in the 10 years, he's not done a bad work. I think he's impressed the women at least.
I tell you what Nitish has done. Personally, I tell you what Nitish has done. Like, I would always go to my village is in Bharatpur. And I've never voted for Nitish all my life. In 2003-2004, when I used to go home, I used to land in Patna. I used to stay back the night in Patna. Next morning, I would take a car to go to Bharatpur. Right now, in the post-2004, whenever... I'll tell you an interesting thing. That was in January of 2006. I took a flight where I landed at about 10 in the night. I called up one of my local friends over there, and he asked me over to come for a drink in Bakipur Club. I said, man, are you mad? This is Patna and this is 10 p.m. He said, come. I went to Bakipur Club, and to my surprise, I saw families. There were families who were partying there at 10, 10:30 p.m.
So
Law and order situation improved. You could take a car from Patna to Bhagalpur at midnight without the risk of getting kidnapped on the way.
Which essentially was an NDA government.
Nitish was the face of it.
But I think so both of them, BJP as well as the JDU, both of them
You are saying is something that I really understand, something that I really appreciate. There is this huge apprehension that if Lalu Yadav starts controlling the administrative machinery of the state, will it take Bihar back to the days of
I would rather
in the coalition, Lalu Yadav, I don't think he would be given that much of an influence.
If you see Lalu Yadav gets larger seat than Nitish Kumar, he'll be controlling. And secondly, one more thing, don't ignore this fact that the Yadavas community itself are thinking, are we imposed by a leaders like ninth pass leaders now?
Exactly.
Let me ask this question. Let me ask a similar question.
Come again.
Is Lalu Yadav's son winning Raghupur? What's your take on that?
As per my knowledge, one seat is coming up. Tejaswi is winning and another son.
No, which one? The one elder in affidavit or elder in age?
What's wrong with these politicos? I mean, no one is able to impress. No Chirag Paswan, nobody.
So Chirag Paswan is impressive. He has got a good fan following.
Khana Raja Chirag is better than others, but let's talk about in holistic figure, then where he doesn't stand.
See, adding to what he told about Bhagalpur, my maternal place is in Chapra, it's a village in Chapra. So, and my hometown is Purnia. So from Purnia to Chapra, us gaon mein jaane ke liye, what we had to take an overnight bus from Purnia to Patna. Now from Purnia to Patna, you have government luxury buses. Mind it, Mercedes ki buses running from Purnia to Patna. So you took an overnight bus, which starts at 9 p.m., reaches Patna by 5, 6 a.m. Now you go to Patna, you take another bus, Khatara bus, from Patna to Chapra, which is another 5, 6 hours. Ideal time is 4 hours, but considering traffic, road and all, 6 hours. From there, you had to go to the village, which was another 6 hours. So you start late at night and you reach next day in the evening around 7:30-ish. This time, June 2015, I started from my home 6:30 a.m. on my own vehicle. And I reached that village by 2:30 in the afternoon and I had lunch there. Now, one might argue that road is a national highway and government. But go and tell that to the voters.
No. Voters are intelligent enough to understand.
same day afternoon I reached from morning.
All of us accept this fact, there is a good infrastructure development by Nitish Kumar in 10 years. We don't deny this fact.
I have a second point to add.
See, communities are also different communities, where are we heading now?
Okay,
no doubt, Lalu Yadav has given a call in 1990. But what after that? People wants to move.
Okay, let me finish my point. My point has a second side to it. So we agree that Nitish did infrastructure and lowering the crime rate and all. Point B, when we talk about an upcoming Jungle Raj and all, tell me, when a BJP member of parliament, and not just a politician, a person like R.K. Singh goes and tells about tickets being sold to people like Shahabuddin ki sharpshooters.
ADR
comes up with a report that maximum candidates with criminal background is BJP. So
do I fear candidates from JDU is just like 10% less or like 20% less. It isn't a huge difference. I think a lot of candidates from Bihar are in any case.
I'm saying, how can you, having sharpshooter of Shahabuddin as a candidate, as alleged by your own sitting MP, right, saying that you sold it in 2 crore rupees, how can you say that you will not have
a lot of people realize that
leave R.K. Singh, but do we all know that Shahabuddin sharpshooter got a ticket from BJP?
Maybe one, but I think he made a list about at least 4 candidates, 3 of them were wrong. He made a list about 4 candidates, 3 of them actually did not get tickets, only one of them did.
It's very isolated. And I think,
let's ignore Shatrughan Sinha and R.K. Singh.
Yes,
considering their situation,
Rudy did not get tickets for his candidates. So if you start isolating, you'll have to isolate about 25 of BJP MP. So let's not start the process of isolation.
No, I'm just saying.
Before we wrap, let's do a quick, we've got very diverse views right here, you know, in this room only. So one by one, I'll get a, we'll try and reach to some predictions. It's too difficult and complicated an election to call. Nitesh, who's going to win Bihar?
Look, this is neck-to-neck fight. Most probably, JDU Alliance.
You've been batting for India.
Doesn't matter. I was giving you the realistic situation.
I hope my vote does some benefit. JDU.
Harsh.
So the candidate in my constituency is a Congress candidate, though.
Siddhant.
It's not the NDA, but it's definitely Modi.
I think it's going to be a neck-to-neck elections, but BJP will scrape through.
Okay, so we have 3-2. I am reserving my vote.
No, how can you reserve what?
I am reserving my vote because I know it's an extremely difficult and
complicated
election.
At least come up with something. Give me something.
My prognosis is that both the alliances will get 40% votes for sure. 15% of the votes will go nowhere. Another 5%, whoever gets 3 out of this 5% is going to have 170 to 180 seats.
And Simanchal is going to
get the
make a big change.
Yeah. What is your prediction? Who will get the 3%?
I don't know. Too early to guess the mood of the fringe voters, essentially. So that's it, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, Leela, for having all of us here in your newsroom. We'll keep coming back with these discussions. We'll add more friends in this group so that we can have more diverse views on the app.
Almost after every phase. We'll have a discussion almost
after every phase. So,
agla
discussion mein 18 tarikh ko phir 18 tarikh ko agla poll
hai 18 tarikh ko stay tuned
for poll ke baad aa jaiye hamare sath yahan par 6 baje hum fir milenge 18 tarikh ko aur bhi zyada log honge hamare paas aur zyada diverse views honge hamare paas aur hum milte rahenge.
Let's have the expert views.
Yes, thank you.